Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be all about my Ulta haul that I went on for my birthday a couple weeks ago. My husband got me a $100 gift card there and I went with the intention of only spending that $100, but I ended up spending another $100. You would think $100 at Ulta would be a lot of makeup, but it's really not. So I just wanted to go over a few things that I picked up. I am wearing some of the products on my face right now. Sorry, I just got off work and my face is hella oily, but I didn't want to powder my face yet because I got some pressed powder that I wanted to show you on camera how it works. So yeah, if you guys want to see what I picked up at Ulta, then just keep on watching. All right, so I'm just gonna kind of go at random and kind of just pick through everything. I have my receipt here so I can let you know how much I paid for every item. Yeah, $200 worth of makeup. That sure adds up fast. So first things first, I got the, and I've already kind of used some of the stuff because it was a couple weeks ago and everything, some stuff's in packaging, some stuff isn't not in packaging, so hopefully you guys don't care. But I got the Naked Skin Ultra Lightweight Liquid Skin Foundation. I've tried this before, and I think I got the wrong shade. I feel like this is too light for me, so I might... Well, I've just been using like a shit ton of bronzer, but I feel like I might need to get a darker color. But the last time I used this last summer, it was, I think, 5.5, and I got 5.0 shade this time. So I think it'll be okay, but this is freaking expensive. I like it for the summertime because it's lightweight, and as you can see, it's not like heavy coverage because you can still see like my breakouts popping through, but it's enough coverage that I need for just an everyday look. I don't know if I'll repurchase this again because I like it, but I feel like there's more lightweight foundations at the drugstore, but I just figured since I had the gift card that I would just get it one more time. So it's really liquidy. You can hear like it's shaking and it sounds like a can spray, but it has a pump, and I mean, it's all right. I wouldn't like say run out and buy it, but it's okay. This foundation was a whopping, I don't even know if I want to know how much this foundation was, $40. I had a couple points. No, it's normally $40. I thought I had points on here, but I guess not. So yeah, 40 bucks. I don't know, now that I'm like, oh my gosh, I paid 40 bucks for this, but actually my husband paid 40 bucks for this. So yeah, that's that right there. Next, we are moving on to the Becca Ever Matte Poreless Primer. This came in this box and this is what it looks like. I have bought this before. I had somebody recommend it to me when I got married for our wedding to use it for the wedding day. I have large pores in this area, all on my T-zone, and I get super oily. So somebody had suggested it to me because it's like a really, it's a really mattifying primer. It's gonna last me a while, but this was $36. I mean, look how tiny this is. You get 40 milliliters, 1.35 fluid ounces, and you only use like a tiny, tiny pea size amount, and I just put it like, press it into my skin right here and on my forehead and on my chin. But this is my face after wearing my foundation all day long. And I think I took it back the first time I bought it because I really didn't see a huge difference. But I do feel like it has mattified my face the best out of all the primers that I've tried. So I normally typically use this Makeup Forever Skin Equalizer, but this isn't like super mattifying to me. It more just clears my pores. But this, like if you use too much, it leaves like white stuff on your face, but I feel like it does mattify. It just, I think I'm just an oily beach and nothing really works. So I don't know. I'm gonna end up keeping this because like I said, it's gonna last me a while, but do I think it's worth 40, 30 something bucks? No, I do not, but I'm gonna keep it anyways. So that's the Becca primer. If you are an oily beach like me, you might want to try it, but I don't know. I don't know. Does any of this stuff really do what it says it's going to do? No, but we still buy it. So moving on. Oh, with that Naked, I got something. A complex primer. So this is supposedly supposed to be for pores too, but I haven't tried it. It's just a sample. It's actually a pretty good size sample. That's it right there. So I'm actually kind of excited to try this. I haven't heard the greatest reviews on this Urban Decay stuff, but it's another primer and I figure why not? Just give it a try. It's a free sample. So that also came with the stuff that I got for free. Now moving on. Oh, with that Becca, I did get another sample to try. What I thought was kind of cool was this Opal Becca highlighter. It's in the color Opal. It's really, really pretty, and I've seen everyone on YouTube have it and rave about it, and it's like hardcore shimmer in your face kind of highlighter. So there it is. It's really pretty. I'm not a huge highlighting person, but I feel like this is the type of highlighter size that I need in every highlighter, because what the hell am I going to do with a highlighter that is like, I don't know, the size of a huge pan that like I will never ever ever use up. I wish more highlighters were sold in these little tiny ones, because I feel like even this size, I still ain't gonna use this whole entire thing. Like, who's gonna put that much shimmer on my face all the time? So yeah, I can't find it, but yeah, I wish highlighters were sold more often in this size. So I got that free sample with my Becca stuff. And then moving on, I did buy the Kaboom, Kabrow, actually, Benefit pomade, and I got the color 4, and it looks like this. Now, this stuff was a little spendy, too. It was $24, and I feel like there's so many pomades on the market right now, but I've really been wanting to try it, and I like a lot of their brow products. It's just, I just hate spending $20-something on something for my brows, but I've tried different pomades, and some of them are, like, thick and stiff to work with. I heard the Anastasia one's really, like, with pomades, if you're not careful, it gives you, like, bam, brows. So, I don't know. With this, I do feel like I can tell that I'm wearing a pomade, but I really like this little tiny brush. So, it looks like this, and I'm sure you guys have, this is, like, none of these are new products. They're all on the internet, but they're new to me because I just bought them. But this little brush comes out like this on the top. And what you can do is put it in this top part here, I think. Yeah. And it makes it longer so you can, like, do your brows. But it's just your typical gel pomade. It's small. But, I mean, I don't need a huge one because this is going to take me forever to use. I do like the consistency of it, and I do really like this brush. But I don't know, like, $24. Why the hell do we, why do we buy stuff like this? It's because it's an Ulta, that's why. It's so cute and little. I do like it. So if you guys are really into brows, I would suggest maybe trying this out. I've been happy with it so far. It's not a product that I use every single day, because for the most part I use pencil or just powder when I'm in a hurry. But with that, I did get a free sample of the Precisely My Brow pencil. And I've been wanting to try this too, but again, it's like freaking $20. But it's just this little sample size one. It's really cute and little. And they gave me the color 3, I think. It's pretty dark, but I do like the, that's the color right there. I do like the brow pencil itself. It's really easy to work with, and it's not too stiff. Sometimes I feel like with the Anastasia one, it pulls my brow hairs, so a lot of the hairs come out. But this is actually not bad. So it's kind of cool that you got a free sample to go along. So I feel like with these two, okay, $20, all right, even though this was free, but, you know, I think it's a pretty good little deal. So yeah, those were the brow products I got. Now moving on to something, let's see, the Bye Bye Pores Pressed Powder. This is by It Cosmetics. I do not own any It Cosmetics products. This is my very first one that I bought besides brushes that I own that I've gotten on sale. But I've been wanting to get like a really nice setting powder, even though you can find drugstore crap like this. But, you know, it's It Cosmetics and it's very fancy. So I did get it. I feel like I've tried similar powders. I have an e.l.f. powder that looks just like this. So I should test it out to see which side actually holds better. But it does mattify. Like, it does, I don't think it hides my pores, but it does mattify. So that's just like a translucent. It's really finely milled. I'll show you guys with an application right now because I am oily. But I just kind of like put it in my T-zone. Just a little right here. It does come off white, but not to where it's like you can tell you're wearing white powder on your face. I haven't tried any like flashbacks with it, like, so I haven't worn it at night yet and like pictures and stuff, so I don't know if it flashes back, but you can see that it does work with mattifying your face. So I mean, it's a good powder. Do I think it's worth $30? It was $30. Do I think it's worth $30? Hell no. But again, I bought it anyways. So yeah, I don't think I'll repurchase this again, but it's just a translucent powder and, you know, it is what it is. There's a few powders that I've been wanting to try actually at the drugstore that are coming out, and I just placed another huge order on Ulta, but it was only like $60 because I had points and stuff. But it's a new brand that just came out at the drugstore, well, at Ulta. So I'm going to be filming that as soon as I get the products in the mail. So yeah, that is that powder. I don't know. If you're bougie and you want some like fancy ass high setting powder, then buy this. But if not, I would just stick with my, let's see. I actually really like the Wet n Wild pressed powder. I think it just does the same thing. So yeah, that was that. And then I got a couple nail polish colors. This is the color Flying Dragon. And I got another one, but I don't know where it's at right now. But it's just this like purpley color. And I could have sworn it said buy one, get one 50% off. But when I looked at my receipt, I did not get buy one 50% off. They charged me for both. So I thought I got a deal, but I wasn't. Whatever. Then I got this brush that I'm super excited about. It's the Eco Tools. I took the thing off already, but it's like this, like really fluffy, almost like a dual fiber brush. And that's what it looks like. And I got it mostly for like blush and just, bronzing, but I feel like it's kind of stiff. I don't know. I probably just wiped off all my makeup because it's like oily on my face, but. It is really soft and I do like it. So, yeah, I like the new packaging on there. This brush was $9.99. So yeah, I mean, I'm not bad. 10 bucks for a nice face brush. You could even use this for powder and stuff. I think it's a good brush. So I was excited about that one. I'll just throw it in my collection here. And then moving on, now if you like to carve out your eyebrows, there's this girl on YouTube. Her name is Juicy Jazz. I swear I'm going to do a video on her because I buy so many things that she says are really good. And she was raving about this NYX Full Coverage Concealer, like really good for wanting to carve out your eyebrows or if you need like a base on your eyelids. I used to use this NYX eyeshadow base and I still use it for like all on my lids and stuff, but I feel like with this concealer, it's like, sorry, I have a cat here on my nose. It's like super thick and it's perfect for carving out your brows. The color I got was beige CJ04 and it just looks like this. It's just like a thicker concealer in the pot. And if you, well, real smooth. If you like to carve out your brows, I would highly suggest getting this. I really like it. Like I said, it's a full coverage concealer in the color beige. They had a bunch of different colors, and I think they had like black eyeshadow ones. I don't know, but it's really good. This was cheap too. It was only $4.99. So I think that's a pretty good deal, $4.99. It almost reminds me of like the Anastasia ones that everyone uses to carve out their eyebrows. So if you guys are trying to get into that, I would suggest getting this. I love it. All right, so moving on, I got this Mario Badescu, I don't know how to say his last name, I'm trying to be all fancy, skincare drying lotion, and it looks like this, and it's like this pink solution on the bottom and this clear stuff on top, so it's supposed to stay, like, you're not supposed to shake it, and I've seen a lot of people talk about using this, like, you put a Q-tip inside and you touch the pink stuff on the bottom, and you put it on zits, like right before, you know those zits that are like, they're not up on your skin yet, but you can feel them and they freaking hurt like hell underneath your skin. Well, you're supposed to put the little Q-tip into the pink stuff and put it on your zit, and then I guess it's supposed to make it disappear within the day. I've actually heard a lot of good reviews on this, and I've really been wanting to try it out. But again, this shit was expensive. This was $17 for this little tiny ass little bottle. $17. Look at that. Come on. $17. But I mean, again, it's going to help with my breakouts, because I do get a lot of breakouts, and especially right now because I'm, on that very special time of the month. And this is going to help out a lot. So I'm actually really excited to actually use this once I do have a nice little zit to come up on my face. Next, moving on, I'm just trying to look at my receipt to make sure I'm not missing anything there. I think there's just a couple more things. The Carly Bible palette. Oh, I got the small one, even though I wanted the new one that just came out, the bigger one. But I don't know. I feel like with the bigger one, I'm only going to use half the stuff that's in there. And when I went into Ulta, this thing was on sale for $9. So I felt like I was like, whatever, I'm just going to get it. It's $9. It's on sale. And I just decided to get the small one. And I love it. I'm so excited that I got it. So these are the colors right here. I'm sure everyone and their mom has seen this already because everybody has it. But they're super pigmented. I really like them. I like this color for the transition. And I've been using these. But a lot of these darker ones I haven't used yet. But in these I've used some of them as highlighters and eyeshadows. If you guys don't have this palette, definitely it's one to pick up. I just, like I said, didn't get the bigger one because I probably wouldn't have used all the colors in there. And I think it's still $20 and I only paid $9 for this. So yeah, I was really, really happy about this one. And then I got this Physician's Formula. It came in this packaging, but I already took it out. This eyeliner pencil or eyeliner booster. It's like a felt tip liquid liner pen. Like, see. And it's really, really pointy. So I got this because I've heard a lot of reviews online and they've gotten good reviews, and it actually makes it really easy to do a wing. So there's some little swatchy swatches right there. It's not super black though. I wonder if they have a different black, because I feel like it's just not as black as it should be. Like, it almost looks gray to me, but it does work really easily. I don't know. To me, it's not like super black. That's the only thing I don't like. But maybe they had like a very black. I don't know. I'll have to look again. But this again was not cheap, but I do like how easy it is. This one was, oh, where is it? $9. I guess that's not bad. Physician's Formula, $10.99 for a little felt tip pen. It does dry matte and it does stay really well. It's just not as black as I want it to be. So I don't know. There's one from Tarte that is really black and I've heard really good reviews, but I just don't do liquid liner enough to spend $20 on an eyeliner pen, but I might have to get it. I don't know. We'll see. But this one's good so far. If you're looking for something that's going to be give you like an easy wing and like not be hard and you can just do it real quick, I would suggest getting this. So yeah, that's all the stuff that I got at Ulta a few weeks ago, and as you can see, it's not that much stuff, and it was $200. So everything that I did buy, there's some hits, some misses, but I'm going to keep everything because why not? I already have it, and I started using it, and I just hate returning makeup because I know they're going to just like throw it away, and what a waste. So I'm going to end up keeping everything. But there are a couple random things that I want to talk about really quick that I have bought that I just wanted to share with you guys in this video really fast. And with my eyebrows, I wanted to share something that I have had for a while and I used in one of my videos. It's this Brow Precise Fiber Volumizer, and it has these like little fibers in it on this brush. So when you comb it through your brow hairs, it like fills them in. So what I've been doing lately on my brows is I've been using the Brow Gal little quad that we got in our box last month, and then instead of using my setting gel that I have been using, the Maybelline one, or what, L'Oreal I think it is, I don't know, the one that you guys always see in my videos, I feel like that it's still good, but I feel like the staying power to hold my brows, my hair in place, like it doesn't do it as well as it used to do. I feel like it still lets my brow hairs kind of fall down, but this keeps them in place. Like, holy cow. I used to have the Anastasia one, and that one held my bras in place too, but I felt like it was really crunchy feeling. Like, this one does too, but it has color in it, and I just feel like it has made my eyebrows look so cute. I have it on my eyebrows. My eyebrows look so cute, really. I feel like they look good. I have it on my eyebrows right now, and I really, really do like it. So I just wanted to shout that out to you guys. If you're into brow gels or anything like that, try this one out. I promise you, you guys are really going to like it, and it's from the drugstore. So I think it was probably less than 10 bucks. And the color I have is medium brown. So if you need something to hold up your brow hairs and make you look like you're surprised all day long, then try that stuff out. And then this was a poo for me. I don't know what the hell I was thinking getting hydrating stuff for my face because I'm oily as hell, but I got this, I don't even know how, Himalayan made, I don't even know what the hell is how to say it. I got this online on Amazon, and I think I paid 20 bucks for it, which kind of sucks because I'm stuck with it and I'm probably going to still use it, and it's just going to make me like oily every day. But it's supposed to be like a primer, and it says to blur, minimize your pores, hydrates, and plumps. I don't think it does anything but make my face oily. This is that, I don't know, that it's just not really doing anything, and then the days that I wear it, I try to just put it on the outside of my face and then use the Becca one like on the inside, but still, again, I feel like my whole entire face is an oil slick, and I think this is the reason why. But they had another one that I wish I would have bought. It was just for mattifying and filling in your pores. If you guys are oily and then you're looking at this, I would get the blue one instead of this one, because this one, it ain't that great. So yeah, $20 down the drain, and I'm gonna cry every time I use it. Anyway, so that's the other stuff that I got to share. I don't have anything else to share with you guys right now. Like I said, I put in an Ulta order just today, so hopefully in like another week or less than a week, I'll get that stuff, and then I'll definitely be doing a first impressions because it's like a new brand that just came to Ulta. Oh, my cat hair, I swear, I always have cat hair on my face. So I'll definitely be doing a video once I get that stuff, and I want to do a tutorial, even though there's probably like a million tutorials on this palette. I do want to use some of this new makeup so you guys can see it in action, because like I said, I have some of it on right now, but I'd rather do like a tutorial using everything so you guys can see how everything works. So I think I'll film that next. Let me know if you guys are interested in that. So yeah, that's it for right now. I'm going to go ahead and end this video. Sorry it's all over the place and I'm all oily and not very cute in this one, but you're just going to have to deal with it. Yeah, so until next time, I will see you guys soon. Okay, bye!